How good is Germany's newest KF51 Panther main battle tank? Germany has unveiled a new main battle tank, its first in more than 40 years. The KF51, also known as the Panther, is bristling with new technology, including a larger main gun, digital computer backbone, and a full suite of defensive features. The Panther even has the ability to counter so-called top attack munitions, like the American-made Javelin missile, that are decimating Putin's army in Ukraine. Germany-based Rheinmetall, an arms manufacturing firm, unveiled the KF-51 Panther at France's Eurosatory Arms Show. The show, held every 2 years, is a showcase for Europe's arms manufacturers to advertise their latest equipment. Rheinmetall unveiled the Panther featuring a grey, black, and neon yellow digital camouflage pattern. If the name Panther is familiar, that's because it is. The Panzerkampfwagen V, also known as the Panther, was designed in 1942 to counter Russian tanks, including the T-34 medium tank. The Panther was one of the best tanks of the war, but was severely hobbled by mechanical and reliability issues. The Panther made its debut in the Battle of Kursk in 1943, and served on both the Eastern and Western fronts, including D-Day and the Battle of the Bulge. The KF-51 is the successor to the Leopard 2, contemporary of the American M1 Abrams tank. The Leopard 2 debuted in the early 1980s and is still in service today with over a dozen armies worldwide. The Leopard 2 has been steadily upgraded for decades, with the latest version being the German Army's Leopard 2 A7. Unfortunately, like many upgraded systems, eventually there comes a point when it becomes impractical to keep adding new stuff to the old system. The only way to move forward is to design something completely new. Panther is that new tank. It appears to use the basic hull design of the Leopard 2, though the shape of the hull suggests newer, thicker armor along the front and sides. The Panther keeps the Leopard 2's lines over the engine compartment, but with a pronounced bulge. Despite this, the Panther reportedly still has a 1,100 kilowatt, 500 horsepower engine, the same amount of power available to the Leopard 2, so there might not be much difference to the power pack. The Panther's turret is bigger with sharper angles and a much larger overhang over the engine compartment, the latter to both store larger, heavier main gun ammunition and to act as a counterweight to the new 130mm main gun. The KF-51 is the first production tank equipped with a 130mm main gun, a break from the current 120mm standard. Although the NATO countries, particularly the United States, Germany, and France, experimented with the larger 130mm caliber in the 1990s, the end of the Cold War and relatively good relations with Russia made that unnecessary. The new gun, named Future Gun System, FGS, is largely in response to the new Russian T-14 Armata tank, which was first unveiled in 2015. Rheinmetall claims FGS has a 50% longer kill range than the older 120mm guns. According to Europäische Sicherheit und Technik, the new gun is a 130mm L52 gun, meaning the barrel length is 52 times the diameter of the barrel. That comes out to 6,760mm, or 22.1 feet long. The barrel is also fitted with a futuristic-looking shroud, but it's not clear how it contributes to the efficiency or effectiveness of the tank. The KF-51, like the Leopard 2, uses an autoloader for the main gun. This results in a three-man crew consisting of the tank commander, gunner, and driver. The American M1 Abrams tank uses a human loader instead of an autoloader, resulting in a crew of four. KF-51, however, has room for a fourth crewman, according to Rheinmetall, acting as either a company-level commander or a drone operator. The KF-51 is equipped with a 12.7mm, .50-caliber, coaxial machine gun mounted next to the main gun. This is a larger and heavier gun than coaxial machine guns on older tanks, which typically mount a 7.62mm machine gun. The larger machine gun gives the gunner the ability to engage softer, less protected targets such as trucks, light armored vehicles, artillery pieces, and ground troops without wasting 130mm gun rounds on less heavily armored targets. The Panther is equipped with a number of other new features. The tank includes outward-facing digital cameras, giving the crew 360-degree visibility without exposing themselves to enemy fire. A second 7.62mm machine gun can be remotely operated from inside the tank to target drones and ground targets. The KF51 can launch 4 reconnaissance quadcopters from the turret, allowing the tanks to conduct their own local reconnaissance. A drone launcher is built into the turret, capable of launching 4 Hero 120 loitering munitions. The Israeli-made Hero 120 has a flight time of 60 minutes and packs a 9-pound warhead. Hero 120 will allow Panther tanks to engage targets beyond their line of sight, such as behind hills and tree lines. Top attack weapons like the Swedish Enlaw and American Javelin have proven devastatingly effective in Ukraine, firing an explosive charge down into a tank's thin roof armor. Most Western tanks are similarly vulnerable, and Panther's top attack defense system is the first known system devoted to tackling top attack weapons. It's not clear how the new defense system works, with rumors it may involve the quadcopters moving to intercept incoming rockets and missiles. One of the most interesting things about KF-51 is that it weighs just 59 tons. That's relatively svelte by modern standards and will make for an agile, sprightly tank. The latest version of the M1 Abrams weighs 73.6 tons without features like a larger gun, loitering munitions, and drones. Rheinmetall states that the tank uses active defenses, active protection systems that shoot down incoming anti-tank rockets and missiles, reactive defenses, explosive tiles that deform a molten anti-tank shaped charge, and passive defenses, steel composite armor, to protect the tank. KF-51 could lean more heavily on lighter active and reactive defenses than heavier passive defenses, lowering the overall weight of the vehicle. The big question is whether anyone needs a new tank like the KF-51. Russia's armored forces have performed abysmally in their invasion of Ukraine, with dated tanks and poorly trained crews. Russia's tank corps has been badly decimated and poses less of a threat than ever before. Then again, KF-51's new, innovative features and bigger gun are beyond what the West's current crop of tanks, first developed in the 1970s and 1980s, can bring to the battlefield. Overmatching the threat is a safe bet, but an expensive one.